right. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here to Gamescom. We are about to get into our final match of the night, of the group stage here, of the major event. But first, we're going to hear from nothing himself, from Cloud9, with, well, I mean, basically, I mean, how valid do you think the title Comeback Kings is at this point, man?
Yeah, I don't know, Comeback Kings. We got both those eco rounds, but yeah, it's maybe valid for
right
group,
there.
Right?
I mean, right there, right your there. Eco rounds, that yeah, second yeah, round
that,
each
that was
half.
Pretty epic, both times. I know, man. Brutal pistol rounds. We should have won the CT1, I think, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Definitely should have maintained a little bit smarter play. Hiko peaked by that jungle, and we just weren't able to keep the advantage.
There were at least a couple of rounds. I think the most impressive one was the last 2-1-4 retake towards that A-bomb site, where Dignitas probably could have ended up either maybe winning or even forcing overtime at that point. Can you try and summarize what happened, what really happened in that retake?
Is that the one where Dupree got the triple?
That towards the A-bomb site when it was, I think it was fought the 28th round, 29th
that
round.
That was Dupree, right? Yeah, when he got the triple. So he pushed through the smoke. And honestly, it felt good. The retake felt good because we still had even numbers. And then I threw a molly through the smoke, and I saw Dupree walking through the smoke. Literally the easiest kill ever. But instead of me pulling out my M4 after the Molotov, I pulled out a nade and then my pistol. So I started whiffing on him with my pistol, and then he killed me and two more. Yeah. But I should have killed him right away. And I blew it, and I literally like smashed my keyboard thinking, okay, we have to play for the tie. And then I picked my head up, and Spencer and Sean were still in it. Spencer stayed patient by the window room and got a pick. And then it was 2-on-4. And then they started the retake, and Dupree was in the jungle. They had to worry about him, but Dupree hid for some reason. And I think when Sean finally got through, he got the auto sniper kill. Spencer killed the guy right below him in between the two boxes. Then it was a 2v2. And when Sean got on the bomb, I don't think that the slope guy heard him on the ramp.
Yeah.
And I was kind of just like, he's not peeking. Oh, my God. And then I thought the jungle guy would just swing and fight Spencer because he was low. But he didn't fight right away. And then Spencer killed him. And then we defused the bomb. I got up and basically roared at him. I just was like, come on, Dignitas, you gotta win that round.
All right, we are going quickly into the next game. We don't have a lot of time here, but I do want to ask you, Titan versus Dignitas, the next game coming up. Who is going to win this one?
I think Dignitas will.
Dignitas might take it.
What map are they playing?
Nuke.
Yeah, that's
tough,
rough.
Cold.
Wow, they're both insane. Honestly, Titan, if they start CT side, will probably win.
All right.
I think it's all about who's offense.
Well, all right, Jordan, thanks for joining. We're going to have to go quick. Hopefully we
you
can catch you later
love
in the
me
tournament.
No, I know, Jordan. I don't want you to go, man. I want you to stay with us.
I'm kidding. Thanks,
we'll
guys, for the interview.
Later, I
love you both. Thank you.
All right. Take care, man.
Thank you very much. Let's see if we can't switch it on over here. We are going to be on Nuke, and once we do, we'll slowly disappear Jordan out of here, and we're going to be all right. So, yeah, moving into it, Semler, what do you think?
And somehow Pasha and Bialy have snuck into the studio and are going to be watching the game live next to us. So we have now beginning Nuke, the final match of this night, of this group stage, of this major group stage, basically. And it looks like we are counting down through the warm-up. 15 seconds left.
Yes, indeed. And we are going to have to find out how this is going to unfold. The Nuke is a map that Titan play very, very well. And it may be one team in the world that does it even slightly better. And that's Dignitas. And I do mean slightly. I think we're talking about really, really tiny margins here. This is a map that Titan for a while were the best team in the world at. And we'll have to see if they can become that again. Beating Dignitas potentially could be a step in that direction, I think.
Now, one thing that we did miss here is that... nothing. I mean, he put it down that basically it depends on who's going to get the start on the defense, because the offense is going to be crucial. We always talk basically about how Nuke breaks down and how it's such a CT favored map. It's so crucial for the T side to pick up those pistol rounds because they need those easy rounds. It is insanely difficult to deal with an effective CT side who know how to handle themselves once they have rifles. So Titan, they are going to be starting on the T side here on this map, and we have counted down. We are into the pistol round. This is it, all or nothing for both of these teams, and these are two top 8 teams clashing now, but Sipnik starts it off. He finds the headshot on NBK.
That grenade won't connect, unfortunately, but AC's going to instantly disappear, and this is a pretty good start for that counter-terrorist side. Smith's 30 HP, existence also dropping a little bit low. Picking up a pistol round here would be pretty big for Titan.
Oh, it'd be massive. It'd be massive. That's really what they need to get done here. There's no discussion. If Titan don't pick up the pistol, life gets very, very sad and difficult for them going into the rest of this half. So Team Dignitas, It's going to be Scream waiting on main. Rootfoot Fetish instantly gives him headshot straight to the face. AC's alive on the bottom site, and it's just frag after frag raining in. Finally, Existence finds a kill for Titan, but this is it. He gets overwhelmed. Device drops down, and Dignitas will secure the pistol to start here on Nuke. Anders, what's going on?
I'm not even sure if this is real life anymore, because AZ actually got the pick off through the smoke with that USPS, and that is just completely absurd. That was a teammate coming out from Dignitas. Every single member picking up a kill each year. Very nicely done indeed. And that's going to put us into the second round, where Titan, with no bomb plant, are going to be buying armor, and it's not a big surprise here.
No, that's their go-to move. They're the ones who actually, I mean, you know, it's up for discussion as to who started doing this, but they're the ones who made it popular. This is their call right now. Second round going into it, and they go for the P250 armor buy. CZ75 in this case on three of them.
We definitely know that it was NIP that came up with the idea, but Titan made it really, they made it really effective, and they started using it quite a lot, and I think it's, I don't know, we identified kind of with both.
No, I mean, this is it. Now Titan, they're going to take over yard. They've got the smokes, they've got the flashes to be able to get through here, so where exactly do they go from here? That's the question. They're going to be running into Fetish, who's already holding a garage, but Fetish is smartly backing off, giving ground, not willing to give the frag early on to Titan. That's what Titan are looking for, and he does peek with the P2K and picks up the headshot.
Existence does go down eventually to Sipnix up here, so the rest have for Masters, and the fact that they took out Fetish has minimal impact on the game right here, because he only had a pistol. They can't pick up anything up, and Device will take down MBK. Kenny will go down towards the ramp room, leaving Scream to be killed by Dupree. So a pretty stable round from Dignitas, I would say. That's what they needed.
And Device just tapped out. Let's go. L-E-T-S-G-O with that CZ. They are hype on Dignitas right now. That was a very important round that they needed to pick up and crush on, basically. So the second round goes Dignitas' way with minimal losses on their part. And we can see fully bought up on their side. Fetish has that AWP for the yard. And we saw how effective he was on Mirage with it already in his CT's half there. So we have to see if he can reproduce that kind of performance here on Nuke. But the problem is, Kenny S is on the other team. And as soon as Kenny S gets that AWP, it's going to be sad times. But Fetish already, great reactions there. Picks off Smiths.
That's a good point. Fetish with a kill on Kenny as well. Just the pixel showing, and that was enough for the Danish captain to pick up that one. Now NBK and Scream are left here, and NBK is going to go down Scream outside. You brought up a valid point about Kenny and Orbs and this AA courtyard, and oh wow, Scream, that's Fetish caught looking at the birds the wrong way there. Now, on any other map, if you asked me to compare Fetish to Kenny, I'd say it's not even a contest. Kenny's going to win almost 100% of the time, but on this particular map, Fetish has like an eerie ability to hold down that AA courtyard. I still think Kenny's going to be able to do it, but I'm no longer anywhere near 100% sure. Well,
clearly he's on point right now, Fetish, because that was a peek from Kenny with a knife out about as fast as it gets.
Yeah.
And Fetish still finds the pixel to nail him on. So now we go into the first buy round here for Titan. They've eco'd twice, and now we get to see exactly what they've got in store for us here now that they have rifles in hand. Smoker's there, nades are as well, and well, Fetish, he has not given up control of yard, as you say. He finds the first frag out here. Once again, Smith gets caught peeking, and this is not going Titan's way. Already here, fourth round, and they're down a man. And if they don't win the pistol round on the T side, they absolutely have to pick up the fourth round.
Can't let that Demon's Husk freight train, as you've been
leave
saying,
the station. They can't let it leave the station. Once it gets on the tracks, it's like you have this ultra-powerful train basically chugging away, chugga, and then they're going downhill to boot. And then they've got rocket boosters on that train too, Anders. It gets completely out of control if Dignitas starts to roll here on Nuke. Nobody wants to play them on Nuke. It's just like Mirage. They are terrifying on the CT side.
Yeah, you have to be a little bit crazy to try and make it work here. Titan, still first half, they have a lot of room to maneuver with here, but winning the fourth round would be a big step in the right direction. And after they lost Smiths outside, they're sort of just all walking around lobby here, trying to hope for a pickup, but Kenny's going to go down to AC, and now Fetish with another kill outside, takes down MBK, the bomb is dropped as well, and there's only 27 seconds left.
Yeah, they're running out of time here, Titan. It comes down to Existence and Scream, the headshot machine, to quote Kyanite. But this is Scream basically running around. He got, like, versus Cloud9 last night, I think he had like 28 frags, and 86% of them were headshots, which is just a disgusting ratio right there. So that really is Scream. But it does look like Titan, rather than face it, They're going to go ahead and just try and hold on to these guns, make sure that they can hold on to the gear. Scream caught in a bit of a box right now, but it doesn't look like Titan are going to be able to hunt him down. And Existence is all the way back in T-Spawn. So they will be able to hold on to these two AKs, make use of them in the next round. Only problem here is, if you're new to the stream and if you're new to the CS mechanics, is that by living through the time allowed in that round, on the T side, you don't get any money. And we can see the effect that that has. Existence, $0, 150 on Scream. Not a whole lot to work with this round.
And the rest are not going to force it up here on the Titan side. So they want to make sure they have the proper equipment. Just going to hope for those AKs to open up something outside here. 4-0 for Dignitas, and they do come out of this round as well with everyone alive. And that's a big problem for Titan. They need to start killing members of this Dignitas team.
Basically, they have to start landing some shots. I mean, it's just a confidence issue as well, really. If you feel like you're impotent, like you can't actually get anything done, that's not going to help, especially when you're already on the T-side of Nuke and you're facing one of the best CT teams on this map in the world. So Dignitas, I mean, Fetish again leaping, going to spot out Scream. He sees him, goes for the shot, not going to get it. But he now knows, second try, nothing there for Fetish. So two shots missed there for Fetish. He's deciding to change up his position so he can't get overwhelmed. If they were looking to try and close the gap there, Titan, it's not going to happen because Sipnix has now got control of Sky.
And in the brief break we had here, I did manage to run into a couple of the members of Dignitas, and a lot of them were really, really angry. Fetish actually one of the guys that kept it a little bit more cool, so maybe he is going to be able to lead the team back into some sort of victory here, because that defeat against Cloud9 is definitely still in the back of their minds. AC and Dupree and Fetish stepping it up, and Dupree with a second shot coming up here, and now Kenny's going to go down as well. That's a second flawless round, and if we look at the scoreboard here for Dignitas, they're really starting to ramp it up, I think. 10,000, that's a lot on Sipnix, and even 9,900 here on AZ.
Well, two of these guys haven't died yet. Device and Sipnix both sitting with 3 and 2 frags. Above the 9K mark at this point. Everybody with a healthy bank on Team Dignitas' side. 5 rounds to their names. And Fetish sitting at the top of the board with 7-0-2. Kenny S, however, does have his AWP this round, so we have to see if he's going to be up to snuff. If he's going to be able to go toe-to-toe with the Danish in-game leader out in the yard. There's the leap. There's the confirmation. They know where Fetish is. Kenny peeks, but Fetish gets him first. And that is worst-case scenario time now for Titan.
Not exactly the ideal start here. More often than not, in the past couple of games we've seen from Titan, it has been Kenny that has to step it up and get the kills if Titan want to win. So for him to go down this early and for Titan to maybe be down 6-0 here, unless they can bring it back, that's not a great start. We're on Nuke, but you do want to have to start. You do need rounds. You need kills. That's what we're talking about here. They need to kill Dignitas members.
They need to get the kill. Yeah, I mean, Fetish managing to make it out of there with 8 HP is insult to injury, essentially. He's trying to put shots through the smoke, see if he can catch anybody there. But Dupree is already alive on long. Chucks a molly out. Scream, he cares not for the flames. He just charges through. But that does slow down the push from Existence and Smiths, his two teammates who have his back right now.
Oh, Scream, very nearly with the timing. Could have caught Dupree then, but I think Dupree maybe either heard him or just caught a pixel there. Good opening from Existence. Going to take down one more, and it's going to be a 4-on-4 here. And he's pushing up towards Hell underneath that ladder.
Now it starts to get a little bit interesting here. AC making the wise move, deciding to back off and get onto this B-side proper. Only problem is that there's already a man alive, but that is Dupree, who managed to remove Scream from the window room, and he's going to look for more here. Managed to find Smith, but Smith acts first. AWP at work, and we're into a 2-on-1 now. Smith, last man alive, and he gets naded into oblivion. Device leaping down for the heroic finish, but that is now 6 rounds on the board. Dignitas, their defense is impervious right now.
That was such a close round as well. That could have really worked out for Titan. Smith's at the end shuffling a little bit around, you know, am I going to fake it? Am I going to put the bomb down? And while he's trying to decide, that grenade just kind of makes up his mind for him. And right now, still, Sipnix and Device have not died yet in this game. They only have 3 or 4 kills each, but they're becoming a bank for Dignitas. Even though they're losing a couple of members that round, it's still going to be just fine. And Titan have to come up with something different. They've already had 6 rounds of trying different things, and nothing has worked.
No, indeed. And they have to be scratching their heads at this point, really just wondering. Once the things start not working, we saw what happened in Hellraisers versus Epsilon. Hellraisers just started milling around on the map, not really sure where to go because they were dying everywhere. Dupree pushed up behind T-Red, gets a triple, and that is a huge play from Dupree. Smith finally puts him out, but it's still a 2-on-4 situation. Smith's down to 25 HP, alive in secret, but he's cut off from his teammate. NBK gonna go leaping through the heavens, trying to catch up with him. Dignitas have got this under control. Fetish is still alive in garage, and he's going to pick off NBK. No support for Smiths.
And that looked so effortless from Dupree. That triple spray down, the first one instant, then looked like he was hesitating for a second on, you know, the second kill, and then he sprayed down both within the space of 1 second. So that was really creepy. That's going to be a 7-0, and Dupree was one of the guys who was really furious, like just fuming when he left the stage. Oh, he was so angry at that loss against Cloud9, and right now he's at 10-0-3, and this seems to be following a trend that we've seen earlier in this tournament where one team loses and then it's almost like they just take it out on the next team in line and go, all right, you might not be the ones who made us lose, but now you're going to have to feel the wrath.
Well, I mean, we've got two examples of it right here next to us. I mean, Bialy and Pasha, they took it out on the, they took it out earlier on I5 Power. It wasn't pretty.
And they are actually carefully watching and studying what's happening here, which is interesting.
There's a knowing smile from Bialy right now. He knows exactly what's going on.
But knowledge is power.
Oh, yes. And you want to do your homework, basically, because this is going to settle who gets second seed out of Group D. So this does have an impact on how the tournament will progress.
Especially because VODS Pro now have revealed that they actually do play nukes. I'm not even surprised. If you're going to be facing Dignitas, you better do a little bit of homework here. Titan have to eco. So we could be seeing 8-0. That actually doesn't mean it's over, but the problem is Titan, they can't actually even force an eco any longer on Dignitas. They'd have to win 3 or 4 rounds in a row to make that happen.
Exactly. That's the real issue now. That window of opportunity that Titan could have had to really get some early on rounds. The pistol, not happening. The second round, no go. The big buy round, nothing. Like, it's just not going Titan's way. Now they run into the blender at ramp. They find Sipnix, but the damage is done. AC with 2, Fetish with 1, and it's just down to Existence now, who's still out in yard, trying to sneak his way through, see if he can't find a frag somewhere to make Team Dignitas spend some of that hoard that they've got saved up. But there it is. Fetish manages to find it. Very easy frag for him. And that is 8 rounds now. And we are well into the mid of the half here, Anders, and we have yet to really see Titan have an impact. Like, they need to really have one of those close close rounds, a nail biter, and it's not even happening. Team Dignitas never really seemed to be ruffled here.
This is one of the hardest parts of the game. It takes such a long time to build up the stamina and the strength and the mental sort of frame of mind to be able to withstand this kind of beating and hope and just wait, look for the one round where you're going to win it and then look for the straight comeback. And I think Titan do have that, but until it actually happens, it's all just theoretical. They need that one round, and then they need to make that round a double and a triple, and they need at least 4 rounds on the first half here.
Well, Scream managing to get a good punish on AC, who decided to play aggressive and push into radio. That's right into Titan's waiting arms, and there is the opportunity. Dupree getting sprayed at through door. That's not going to help him either. This is Titan's big opportunity now going in. They've got one kill. They've dropped a man to half HP, and Kenny is still looking towards ramp. We'll see if he gets the opportunity to take Sipnix out, who is currently waiting patiently for the angle. For the opportunity.
Inching forward here. If he keeps doing this, it could be really good. Sipnix, I'm not sure he's going to be able to stand on this AWP. Kenny moves forward here, and he looks the wrong way, and Sipnix could have taken a kill then. Fetish outside is going to be dropping Smith, so now Titan, what are they going to do?
They're going to try and push through on ramp here, but Sipnix has already fallen back. He's got the info for his team. He's still at full HP. He's done some damage to Kenny. And that's going to slow things down now for Titan. Sipnix now alive in window room. Great position for him to be in. And a smoke has been used to get rid of him, but Dupree alive in vents is going to get confirmation that, yes, in fact, they are pushing down ramp Titan. They are interested in this B site. And with 26 seconds left, Titan really don't have many options here. They have to make this happen.
Sipnix, doors open here, so they're going to have to either go and close them or smoke him off or flash him out here. MBK, no bomb plant. 10 seconds left, more or less. And Kenny and Scream are trying to see if they can win this round back. Titan just having no luck at all. Device is going to deny the bomb plant. That will end the round. Kenny with the AWP, he has to die here before the time runs out, and he will at least do that. But I don't know what to say.
Sipnix's position was the crucial one right there. Alive at the doors, long, open, and eyes on the site. Doesn't matter if the smoke is down. As soon as he sees that guy's jumping in there with an M4A4, he goes for the spray. All 30 bullets if it takes it, but he stops that plant from happening.
Yeah.
As soon as that plant doesn't happen, Titan know, well, there's a guy alive at long doors. There's not a whole lot we can do to get rid of him.
They misbought an AWP on Dignitas. I know you're sure it matters, but there was one in Spawner's Vendetta just showed us there. I'm feeling really, really dispirited right now, and I'm not even in the game. Existence gets picked up with a jump. Smith with a good return. That's Fetish down in the courtyard, and that gives them an opening, even though they did lose their in-game leader doing that. Oh, and
we're back. All right, but a bit of a scare there for a second, and Smith manages to set up to pick off Sipnix from Sky. So this is now another big opportunity here. Smith looking in through main, trying to see if anybody's going to be rotating through from Team Dignitas, but Dignitas are really taking their time, currently sneaking their way up from Secret, looking to catch Titan off guard. Scream is looking here, and he will find the headshot first onto Dupree, but a second man is here, and his device going to give it away. He finds the opportunity. He times the peak perfectly, and AC with the flank on Smith. Titan are getting dissected. They're pinned down.
But AC doesn't know that Kenny's up here, I think, so maybe if he just walks out, it's going to be bad. Device takes down MBK. This can't happen. This is heartbreaking. Titan, they had this round. They had it working. Kenny goes down, and AC with the double. Device with the double. That's soul-destroying. Titan should have won that round.
That pain train, it's left the station right now. We need to get Terry Tate, the office linebacker, in here to shut Dignitas down, because this is just rude. Titan have yet to get on the board.
MBK go for a timeout here, which is not an unreasonable situation.
Pasha's just laughing at me and shrugging. Like, he's just like, I don't know what's going on, man. Like, this is ridiculous.
Device hasn't died yet. We're 10 rounds in, and he's still survived every single round.
Yeah, that's actually just obscene. 6-0.
What is, I mean...
You're going into the 11th round and you haven't died once.
And Kenny and MBK have 0 kills each. Yeah, 0, 0, and 10.
Thank you, Ven, for pointing that out.
Yeah. What do you say at this point during a timeout?
What do you say? I mean, if the timeout is used, the timeout is used. So that's what's going to happen here. You can imagine Titan are having the huddle. They don't actually have to use an eco round to do it. They can just go and get one timeout per game. So Titan elect to use theirs now, but really what they have to be saying is, Kenny, our strategy kind of revolves around you getting picks for us. We kind of need you to step up and do that now.
I just can't even imagine.
That's not too much pressure for you, but really, right now, you know, you're our point man in this.
You know, if this was any given Sunday or some other movie like that, you know, you need the timeout. The coach comes in, gives a really inspirational speech, but imagine how hollow those words are going to ring in Titan's ears right now. I mean, if that kind of speech is followed up by the instant result, then maybe that could somehow jumpstart, you know, just electrocute Titan back into this game. But they need something like that.
Well, let's see here real quick. The money is going to be enough for a buy. There's 1950 on Kenny, but there's enough money for Scream and NBK to get bought up. Smiths and Existence have bought as well, so they've got gear. It's still possible. Like, that's the thing. Really?
Nope, it is.
I mean, we've seen Cloud9 run it back twice now. Anything is possible in this group stage.
And on Nuke, it's even more possible.
On Nuke, if they can just get it out of control, basically. If Kenny can come together and really just step up his game and start landing some shots to open up the map a little bit, they need to find a way, A, to deal with Fetish, who is just dominating out in yards. So that part of the map is gone. Sipnik's and Ramp, they have yet to get a real kill on that guy to open things up there. I think they did it one round, but then Dignitas are too good at figuring out exactly what Titan are up to and then rotating the defense in there to cover the gaps.
Maybe the answer is the AYOLO play. Explode, squeak, doll, rush, and just hope you get the first pick off. You get the first pick off, you smoke off heaven, and then you go from there.
That's true. We haven't seen
it's
that play yet.
It's not really a very Titan-esque kind of play, because they are really, you know, a methodical team in that sense, but if nothing else works...
Go for it, really. I mean, at this point, you got to try and pull out everything from
that. They don't actually have a grenade, so that kind of kills that play.
Now, they can go for a bit of a delay if they want. The mollies are going to go down to stop the immediate push. This is Dignitas just being thorough at this point. They don't want to leave any early options to Titan as far as aggression. But Dupree is pulling a bit of a Smith, sneaking up below Silo out in yard. So they have the two lines of defense, basically, for Team Dignitas. They've got Fetish alive, or rather, Dupree alive, covering yard.
Yeah, this is looking really bad. I feel like everyone can understand how hard Titan are fighting right now to get back into it. Flashbang out here, and Dupree will pick up the first kill on Smith. AC falling back into the lower bomb site. And now, can they do it? Fetish making sure nobody actually wraps around towards the A bomb site through the through heaven or hell there.
Exactly, eliminating options. As long as he just stays alive in that hell area, I think they're fine, because he's already rotated his teammates down. Dupree banking, he misses that Molly, and this is a huge opportunity now for Titan. They've got a bomb plant with four guys alive still, two guys waiting in Toxic. NBK's going to be alive on the site. Scream is the point man here. He has to hold off Fetish, who's going to be working his way in from Ramp.
This has got to be it. Scream with a headshot. Can they finally get it home? MBK does go down. Scream is down as well. Still two people hiding inside. Kenny almost falling then. Three on two. The smoke it off here. They know exactly where it's planted. Now it's a one on three. Kenny, can he stop this defuse? It's already happening. He divinizes it once, and that's enough time. Kenny with a double kill. And Fetish is going to die with the bomb. And Kenny gets a triple. And it's a round for Titan. 10-1. It's just about time as well. Now comes the second round. They gotta win it, and they definitely, this is not over. It's not over yet.
It is not, and if anybody, we've seen Titan take these timeouts, and they're the team that really went to it, using eco rounds for timeouts, talking it over, figuring out what is not working for them, and then we see the change already, and we've seen them do this in the past. So this official timeout really working well, because they don't even have to sack a round for it. So now, Titan with one round on the board, enough to get pretty fully bought here. Kenny S has an op again. He's going to be dealing with Fetish, who has the op as well, kind of floating around. But Fetish has actually changed it up, holding from ramp. So Kenny has control of the yard. Is he actually going to have a target to work against here? Sipnik's up on Skywalk, is going to fall back. But he does get confirmation that there are Titan members out there.
Yeah, that is a very different setup from Dignitas with Fetish in there. That gives a lot more control of courtyard to Titan. But at the same time, can they actually make it work? Because they've had control out here before, and now Fetish has moved back towards the window room to see if he can pick anyone off from this position. And Titan inching their way forward out here.
I mean, now they're going to try and work their way past T-Red. Limited smokes, only three here for Titan to work with. Kenny S, it all comes down to his ability to get the entry frag here for Titan. They're going to rush right across, and Fetish picks off the man I just mentioned. Kenny S, the caster curse strikes, and Fetish finds him first. The bomb has been dropped, but it's still well within the realm of possible here for Titan.
Smith's not quite getting the kill here. Fetish trying to escape. He's got the AWP out again. He realizes he can't get up the ladder quick enough. He might get picked off. And now they're going to boost up outside here, buying time for Fetish to actually escape. So that's a little bit of a shame. MBK's very low on health as well. And Sipnix almost gets the kill. Grenade down. He actually almost going to jump up on the player who was boosted up. But Smith goes down. Fetish misses a shot. And now it's 2-on-4 here. And Titan will have their their economy
shattered.
Reset.
Shattered. That's the right word here. Just completely and utterly broke. They're going to be on welfare. Titan, one round.
So there was a tiny detail that Fetish did this round that was it's very, very cool, and it takes a great presence of mind to pull up what he did, because they triple peeked him out in the courtyard, and they did it from three different distances, and he realized the guy that's going to be at the back is going to be Kenny with the AWP. The two forward people are just with rifles. So he waited, he let one guy by, and he shot the guy exactly in the middle that was the furthest back. And that was pretty impressive.
No, it's just Fetish. I mean, the reactions that he's displaying right now, this is the mastermind as well behind Dignitas. He's going to be the one making those kinds of calls. And we see it yet again, success. The boost is going to be up on box. Fetish goes for the flick, not going to land it. And this is an eco round out of Titan, obviously, because they just don't have any more money left. They have to go for this kind of round, basically. But NBK will find a headshot on Dupree with the Glock in hand. Device will come right back at him, though. Take NBK out. And now Fetish close to getting overrun here. He's missed shot after shot. And he finally goes down to Kenny. Good pressure there from Titan.
Picking up an AWP, but not for long. Device is going to deny that. Scream should be going down here as well. And he will. Device, the really quick triple kill, in fact. 12-1, and they could force it up. They could go for three AKs and two Galils on this side, and they are going to do that. I'm not even really much opposed to it, because if they wait, they're allowing themselves at the maximum two rounds.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they have to get rounds on the board. There's no other option. I mean, one round is not enough going into the second half. If Team Dignitas are sitting at 14 rounds when they go to the T side, they win the pistol, that's game. Anything after that, Dignitas are going to have so much room to work with, and with how well they're playing this so far, Titan needs to get the remaining three rounds in this half. There's no discussion. But how do they go about that? Because again, you know, it's like Smith's only CZ, one HE. There are enough nades, however, on three members here. NBK, Existence, and Kenny S. They've got flashes, they've got a smoke, so they can actually try and set things up here, but it does look like it's going to be the A play here. Titan just moving out, but Device hiding in the smoke gets onto that site.
Fetish, Sipnix cleaning up. Device comes in, takes down MBK, and Existence finally returning a kill, but it's not going to be enough. Scream in a 1-on-4, and I think this is actually the first time we've seen Titan really go for that A-bomb side. Every other player has been towards B right now, and it doesn't work, so they, again, no answers. They have just one round that seemed to work where they made the entry and they got down to B and put the bomb down and almost couldn't hold it, but then barely did with Kenny getting a triple.
Yeah, triple kill for Kenny. They go for the upper rush. I mean, this is the play that they have to make. Titan, essentially, they go for the upper rush, but look at this. Dignitas, 15th round, they're just dropping guns all over the place. Device showing off the fact that he does have a howl. but Titan, they're down to pistol and nades. They don't have money again. They never really feels like they had money much in this round. They had a couple rounds where they were able to afford a full buy. After that, it's just shattered buys.
Oh,
and Team
man.
Dignitas just rolling through. I mean, if Team Dignitas get 14 rounds on the CT side, it's almost as bad as VP, you know, destroying High by Power earlier on cash.
Yeah, this is really a similar level of destruction that we're seeing here from Dignitas. That's a pretty good comparison, actually. MBK goes down, of course. Titan really don't have anything for this final round. They forced it up the round before. They're down to pistols and some grenades. Smith's coming in here. We'll be able to drop device, so that's a pretty good kill. A lot more needs to happen.
Yeah, exactly. They have no room. Dupree will return takeout Smiths. And now Dupree rotating up to the top side. Knows there's a guy behind T-Vents, but that's not going to matter because Existence comes in big with two frags here for Titan. They managed to get two rifles as well. And with rifles and armor, this is definitely a dangerous situation now for Dignitas, who are going to have to work their way in. But AC finds one shot, and Fetish is still alive with the AWP. Point blank on Existence, takes him out, and it's down to Scream. 1v2 versus Dignitas, and the bomb has not been planted yet.
Yeah, the Belgian headshot machine. He's going to go straight for the plant. They're not actually going to interrupt him here, so he's going to get the free plant. One on two, and this is really difficult to hold. He's wanting someone to come down so he can make it one on one, but they're crunching from either side, and AC will take him down. No grenades, no nothing at all for Scream to work with here. 14-1 first half for the Danish team Dignitas, and an overpowering performance from Dignitas.
Yeah, overwhelming. 14-2-2 for device at the end of that half. That's ungodly. That's just ungodly. Ridiculous to get that kind of scoreline.
Can you please put on this hat already? Because Titan really need it. There it is. That's what we need. I mean, we already do have two French teams through first in their groups as well, which is very impressive. But Titan can't go out like this. It'd be heartbreaking if they do.
You're just looking for the opportunity, basically, to say that the hat is ineffective, because Titan coming back in this sort of situation, well, the power of the hat, if ever there was a time, if ever the hat was necessary, it's now, Anders.
After this game yesterday with Cloud9, where they just barely didn't make it, it seems almost it's almost too much that they should go out like this at the very end as well. This was the group of tears. We knew that one of these three teams had to leave, and again, I couldn't say from the beginning which one was more heartbreaking.
This situation, this is it exactly. Going into it, looking at this, it's you're talking about three top eight teams. They end up in the same group, and this is because Titan went out in the groups in the last major.
Yeah, they did.
This is really shattering for Titan. They came into this with high expectations. They put all the work into it, boot camp, everything. You name it, the works. Probably one of the most prepared teams going into this tournament, and yet it's Katowice all over again. They lose on one best of one, and now they may very well go out of the tournament having won only one round on the last map to decide it all. Back-to-back group finishes for Titan.
Yeah, and the fact is, it could have turned out so differently if it just done a few things. If they had won that game against Cloud9, they would have had two shots of doing it today instead. And if they had ended up in a different group altogether because of their last finish, now they ended up in a different seed in this group. There are a lot of, you know, coincidences that come into play here that mean Titan just aren't able to connect the dots. But we saw what they did to Cloud9 yesterday and almost won it. So it's not like we don't have evidence of how good Titan is. We do, but it's not enough here.
Well, I mean, they just did not get enough rounds on their T side. That's the thing. You know, the last time we watched Titan play Nuke like this, was it versus the NiP?
Yeah, it was.
And they took the NiP 16-14. Still they a hard-fought battle. But at the end, they looked shaky on the T side. So now we have to see. CT side, it's all or nothing. We are into the game live now, ladies and gentlemen. But Team Dignitas now with a dominant lead, 14 rounds to their name, and Fetish is already tearing them up. Can we get into the game here?
Get in game back, yeah. Fetish with a quick double kill. This is all or nothing. Titan, a must-win pistol round. There's not even any need to say it. Everybody knows it. And it's going to be in CT main as Smith goes down. MBK and Scream left 2-on-4 now. As Scream does pick up a headshot, not sure it's going to be quite enough. Scream in a 1-on-3 has got the kill, but oh, the grenade sent him flying out of the railing. Goodbye, Scream.
Goodbye indeed, and goodbye Titan. They lose the crucial round, but if ever there was a team to pick up the second round on Nuke, it's going to be Titan on the CT side, because they are widely feared by every team going into this map because of this right here, their uncanny ability to pick up the 17th round.
There would be no comeback to match this comeback if Tyson could pick up this round and drive it home.
Nobody could. Yeah, exactly. This would be the comeback, basically, that would be untoppable. 14 rounds in a row on Nuke CT, but AC lines it up on screen, picks him off immediately. No answer here from Titan. They're trying to work a man in through garage again. That's Kenny S picking up this scout. And if ever there was going to be a man to make a difference with a scoped rifle, it's going to be Kenny S. But Fetish finds him first. The headshot is there. And Titan are down two already. Team Dignitas all over the place.
A really, really sad way for Titan to end it. This is what we've been saying a couple of times already. They're not the only team to exit the group stage with the and it being a bit of an upset. Hellraiser is going out as well, which is definitely shocking. And it's the best of one format as well as the veto system coming into play. It's a combination of those two, which meant that Titan couldn't necessarily altogether prevent Nuke. It was a 33% chance it was going to be Nuke, and it was.
It's like, if you get Nuke, it's a worst case scenario for Titan, I think, because, I mean, they're good. They are very good on Nuke, but so are Team Dignitas. Team Dignitas, it's like Mirage level good.
And having the highest seed, they get to choose the side as well.
Exactly.
So again,
team, like, I mean, nothing had it right, basically. It was the team that was going to get the start CT that would have the highest chance of taking this map right here. And now it is NBK alive, 1v5. Gets one kill, the parting shot, but that is going to be it. Device ends him, and Team Dignitas will be securing the second seed in Group D here over Titan. This is it. The groups are over. And we have all 8 playoff teams now, Anders.
Yeah, we do. Of course, we're going to be creating a bracket for you guys and figuring out how that's going to work out. What a way to end the day. We had that incredible game between Dignitas and Cloud9, where Cloud9 came out on top with a ridiculous comeback and some great clutches. And then we have Titan. They've been waiting all day to play this game, and they just couldn't do it.
NBK has been here, I think, since like the first group this morning.
Yeah.
Like, I think I walked out after the first game at break and ran into him then. So, I mean, NBK has been here for a long time.
You see a Titan member, then give him a hug, because I feel like that was... They deserve more of a chance than they got here.
Buy them some wine.
Yeah, that's what it's down to. Ladies and gentlemen, a little bit disappointing, but at the same time, it is the nature of the game. They're not the only ones. I buy power, we're treated to a similar thing from the VODS Pro lineup. That's just how it comes, how it goes down here. Tomorrow, we are in a position where we have Tosspot, Pansy, Richard Lewis joining us. We're even going to have pro players in for some analysis too. It's going to be absolutely fantastic. And it's all best of three games tomorrow. Quarterfinals, and we're covering every single one of them. You guys must tune in. Cancel all other plans you have and join this stream right here on the channel. Semler, what a pleasure it's been.
It has. It's been an amazing ride over the past 2 days. Just excellent games through and through. The best teams in the world here, and they have not disappointed us, Anders.
No.
But you're right. Tomorrow is going to be a glorious day of CS, nonstop, all day, straight through and through. 4 best of threes, every quarterfinal match casted. And the day after that, both semis and the finals.
ESL 1 2014 Cologne will be continued tomorrow. Tune back in.